the housemate subgroup, which Harry and I and a few other people were a part of, our role was to actually find housemates for Adam for when he moves out of home. And we, I guess, had to draft an ad to put out, interview potential housemates, and somehow, hi Mitzi, somehow find appropriate people who we thought would work really well with that, and then kind of introduce them into the process.
And also kind of figure out exactly what role they were going to
That's answer. Also true, yeah.
So, of course, we were really wondering the line between, you know, being a housemate or supporting Ad in a specific way. So that, yeah, took quite a lot of discussion, not only in our group, but also in the
Yeah, there circle. Were a few discussions around the roles of housemates versus support workers versus friends versus what would a regular housemate be expected to do and how it would change in this, you know, unique scenario. The housemates will be expected to be around certain nights during the week and assist Ad in the mornings and in the evenings. So we'll kind of develop a bit of like, I don't know, a roster, which we've worked on, the expectations of when they can be there and how long for. Weekends are a lot more flexible, so Ad will be with our family for some of the time and he'll have paid support some of the time. But there is quite a high expectation on the housemates.
I think we were looking for kind of, you know, open-minded and kind and friendly people. We actually spent a lot of time, especially when we were making the ad, thinking about the wording, because I remember someone said social.
Yeah.
And then we realized, actually, they don't have to be social, they just have to be friendly. There's that distinct difference. Like, they might be a real homebody, not a social person, but that could be great.
The kinds of people that we would look for, I guess, would be, yeah, as Harry said, open-minded, people that Adam would feel really comfortable around, people that wouldn't be a total pushover, like, you know, he can be quite demanding and bossy, and if, you know, it needs to be some strong-minded people as well who can deal with that, and, yeah, just be assertive, but also in a really sensitive way.
The big thing that also came up in one of our meetings when we were doing the kind of what-if situations was we were looking at, you know, so what if this happened? What if housemates don't get along, or someone's not paying rent, or someone's not being as appropriate with Adam, or this and this? And pretty much every time it came down to step one, clear and good communication between housemates before getting, you know, anyone else involved. So I suppose that would be a thing that we're looking for, is like people who can have clear communication and aren't going to be, you know, if they're upset about something, that they can just say it. And we hope, at least, and I know that like Leah and Addie and Tammy's parents are really good at just being like, you know, if you're not happy with something, just tell us straight away and we'll deal with it. And they're very open like that. So it's kind of, you never want to get into a situation where people are resentful or they've been, I don't know, building something up.
Bottling up.
Yeah.
We were hoping maybe for about 6 months span, but we ended up getting really lucky and finding people a lot more easily than we initially thought. Mm-hmm. We thought it was going to be really hard and we didn't know how we were ever going to find these people who were flexible enough to work in with, you know, the openness of the situation, not knowing when they're going to move, not knowing where they're going to move to, not knowing who they're going to live with, like.
So initially we put up the ad on some flatmate websites, including like, I think it's called Flatmates or Flatmate Finder, but they actually, we made a whole nice ad on it, and then they said, oh, you can only do it 1 or 2 months before you're moving. So
That didn't work out.
So we put it on Gumtree, and we got some nice responses. We got a few interested people, but then we got some letters just really nice being like, if I was moving, I'd love to move out with Adam, and it looks like such a great thing, and what a lovely guy, and best wishes.
Yeah, we were really surprised at the responses. We didn't get many, but the few that we did get were like, oh, yeah, cool people.
But I think same with how we've often recruited new support workers for our team, Facebook. So, or just
and through word of mouth
to our mates. Because, for example, as part of our day as a support worker with Addy, it's assumed that we would take a photo with Ad, and that's been helping him chat with his family about his day and chat with his friends. So he has a big collection of photos, and he has a Facebook, and he has an Instagram, right?
Mm-hmm.
So on lots of the support workers' pages, there's all these pictures of Adam having a great time and showing how much we love hanging out with Ad, basically. So if you think about it like this, all of our friends on Facebook have seen Ad, right? So they know it's something really special and good. So then when we do a shout out like, oh, we need a new support worker, I've usually got like 20 people contacting me saying, I'd love to work with Adam. It looks like you just have a fantastic time. So then, you know, he kind of had a presence there. So by the time we said, you know, this is this cool thing that we're doing, Addy's going to move out and we're looking for flatmates, it was really cool that people were interested. So, you know, the three people that we've got as potential housemates, one of them is one of our support workers.
One is a current support worker.
Who has been for the past 4 years.
Yeah.
One was, we were looking for a team leader at the start of the year, and we had three amazing people, and she was one of them. So she, came kind of...
still wants to be involved in a very different way.
Yeah.
Which is amazing.
Yeah, and the other one's just a mate of mine. It's a uni student who's looking to move out, and it's just worked really well. We're really lucky that we found people who are, not only do they want to do it and they're happy with the situation, but they're actually passionate about the whole concept.
And to really like push it forward as, you know, a really like a potential option for many more people,
because
it's, you know, it's not really an option for many people.
Showing people it can be done and how can you how can you do it.
Working out whether to find the house or the housemates first was quite challenging, because we, you know, as people who live in current share houses, like, we would feel more comfortable, I would, in knowing where I'm going to live before I decide to do it. But it, you know, we couldn't actually find a house. We haven't started looking, really, because it's just too early in the piece. So we wanted to find housemates first. So we kind of thought we'll just put the ad out there, see what we can find, and just be really open with people about what we're looking for, where we're looking, where we're going to eventually look, and the kind of place that we're going to look for.
I think that made a difference, being, first of all, like you said, very open. Like, you know, we're not moving now, we don't have a house, this, in a positive way, of course. And secondly, saying what we're looking for, like, we'd love to have a sunny house with this many bedrooms, this many bathrooms in this area. Do you know what I mean? So I think that that helps, so they could see what we were dreaming. Yes.
And hopefully we'll get the place that we are hoping for. But the housemates, you know, were happy to get on board even before knowing where they're going to live.
The relationships were important, kind of building those relationships before actually getting a house, because with Addy and, you know, our whole support circle, it is a long process, and they need to be involved and get to know Addy, and Addy needs to get used to the ideas and get used to new people in his life. So it is a,
Yeah, I guess it's important also to build relationships between the future housemates and our family and the current support team and Adam in the mix and the wider support network eventually, because all of those people and circles and networks and everything are going to be interacting with the housemates and with Adam, you know, hopefully on a regular basis. So it's pretty important for the housemates to be involved at an early stage, and we were really lucky to kind of find three housemates that we're really happy with. They're really happy to move forward and involve them in the process as much as possible.
We started involving the housemates and Adam in the kind of process by, first of all, just kind of social events. So like, you know, for example, one weekend, your parents went away and Chris and Adam had this place to themselves, and they had a little barbecue with all the potential flatmates and just hung out. And so it kind of started off mostly as social, and now we're getting to the stage of
buddy shifts.
Yep, buddy shifts with Adam. So they'll go out with one of the support workers and Addie maybe to work or out swimming or whatever. But and just to see what it's, you know, what's a day like for Addie, and what support does he need, what support doesn't he need. But also we're about to do a kind of, well, I wouldn't call it an induction, but an induction.
We're starting to do some more involved discussions and programs and informal chats and planning with the housemates, getting to know each other a bit more, starting to think a bit more as a cohesive group, and starting to work through potential, you know, not issues, but potential conflicts and things that may come up, and getting them involved to understand, you know, exactly what they're going to be doing.
Because we really found like we were doing all this, all these things like, what if this happened, what if this happened, but it actually felt like that's not really our place to do it. Like, yes, at this point in time we're kind of working on behalf of Addie, and someone will always be able to be there to speak on behalf of Ad, but it's their house. Why should we be telling them how to deal with conflicts? We don't live there. I'd hate if someone did that to my share house. So,
exactly.
So that was quite cool. So we started more and more realizing, no, let's leave that to the housemates, and Addie can be there with someone who, you know, can help
advocate for him.
And they can talk about what kind of rules they want in their house, because it's not our house. It's theirs, yeah.